Welcome back once again to Jack's Tech Corner. This is yet another video tutorial of Photoshop Elements. I know a lot of you have emailed me and said, Jack, what was that BlackBerry tutorial? Sometimes I like to go off base a little bit and just show some other folks new ways of doing things. So I thought I would throw that out there. And I think I'm going to have a few other videos coming on one other subject that I've been playing around with. And I think you're going to be interested in it, so I think that's going to be coming up very soon. Before we get started, like always, if you enjoy this show, please, please, by all means, check out my website, jackstechcorner.com. You'll come to this page. And if you haven't visited for a while, you're going to see a new DVD that's been posted right here. Volume 3 is now posted and ready for delivery. For those that have already been to the site or purchased the DVD, thank you very much. I do appreciate it. And if you've never been to the site before and you're looking for the videos, you have the option of 1, 2, and 3. But you also have the option here to save a little bit of money and buy a full 3 DVD set. Volume 1, 2, and 3, it's only $40 and the $2 shipping. You get all 112 videos. That's all the videos on these 3 DVDs. So it all comes to you in a set. Goes from very basic editing to advanced editing, so I think you'll be really impressed with that. We also have the 2 volume set at the bottom still, for those looking for that, as well as the Mac edition, which seems to be going pretty well. Thanks everybody picked up the Mac edition. If not, there's always a way right here. You can donate to the show, and I do appreciate any form of donations. It definitely helps to pay the hosting costs for the website, as well as equipment if I need anything for the studio. So it helps out, folks. I really appreciate it. Okay, with that said, we're going to get out of here. And we're going to start talking about Photoshop Elements. Now, this tutorial, a lot of people write in and say, Jack, will this work with version 5? Will this work with version 4? You know, I don't use all those versions anymore. But I can tell you that most of the tutorials do work for 5, 6, and 7. I can pretty much guarantee that. And all the DVDs will work for those versions also. And remember, somebody emailed me last week and said, why should I buy your DVD if your videos are on YouTube? Not all the videos are on YouTube. I have a lot of what I call DVD exclusives on those DVDs, so they're not all on YouTube. So that's I just wanted to throw that out there. Now, what we're going to be talking about today is called, I like to refer to it as workflow. A lot of people say, Jack, how do you go about a workflow? How do you flow through your work when you're editing a picture? And really, it's just steps. You just have to think about steps. Each step along the way, you got to think about what you're changing and how you want to change that. So we're working on a picture here, obviously, of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. This was taken, I took this actually off of one of the Gateway Clipper fleet. And if you've never seen Pittsburgh or Gateway Clippers, do a Google search and check it out. I think you'll be pretty impressed. It's pretty nice to get on the river and take a little cruise up and down the river. So let's go ahead and get started with this tutorial on workflow. Now, as you see here, we have this picture. Obviously, I told my wife that the boat rocked a little bit and I took it a little bit crooked. Hey, the camera could have been, I could have been a little bit off. But anyway, it gives us a reason to fix it and fix it up a little bit. So I see a few things here. When you first open your picture up, take a few looks and see what's going on. First thing I noticed is the sky is kind of gray. It wasn't really overcast that day. It was pretty nice out, but the sky kind of grayed out a little bit here on us. The water is kind of a hazy, I don't know, like a mucky look, I guess, or a grayish look. So I thought we would need to change those two things here to actually clean this picture up a little bit. And I thought, how would I go about doing that? Well, the first thing we want to do is we're going to make a background image or duplicate the background. And all we got to do here is do a Control J, and that will duplicate your background image. Now at that point, we can turn this one off. So the first thing I want to do is straighten the picture out. So that's part of my workflow. So we'll go to Image, Rotate, Free Rotate Layer. Make sure you're clicked on the layer you're worked on. A lot of folks are emailing me here getting confused about layers. If you're clicked on the one you're working on, as you'll see through this tutorial, that is the only one being changed. Let's go up here, and we're going to rotate this up just a little bit just to kind of straighten the city back out. There's actually no leaning towers or leaning buildings in the city of Pittsburgh. So let's straighten that out. Now, as soon as you do that, if you notice, I turned off the visual here. This is showing it completed. And this is not, right? So I turned this off. When you turn that off, what you can do now is you can actually crop this picture. So we're just working on this one layer here, layer one. We got the crop tool selected. Let's go ahead and crop. Try to get as much of the edges as possible without getting into the transparency, because you don't want to have to fix that stuff in your picture. Once you get it where you want to, hit the Enter key or click the little checkbox. There you go. Now we actually have a nice straight looking city. Everything looks like it's really good and it's coming along well. The next thing we want to do is we want to select this sky here, the skyline. Now we're going to select the skyline, but we're going to have to work backwards here. We're going to select the skyline, then we're going to inverse it so we actually have this selected, and hopefully when we make a new layer, the skyline will disappear on us. Let me show you how that works. Let's raise our brush size up using the right bracket key. Click on the plus because we're adding to a selection. Let's just go across here. And as you see here, be careful because there's stuff in here that's not selected that we want selected. That's why we need the minus. You might want to lower your brush size using the left bracket key. And we're going to go over these buildings. Go up here. Touch on the top of that. Same with this building. And if you got to lower and raise your bracket key, that's okay if you're working with smaller areas. Alright, let's go up here. And I know everybody's made selections before, right? It's not a big deal. I like when I teach this in class because everybody's trying to be so precise. You don't have to be. The selections are pretty easy. They work themselves out. And they say, boy, Jack, how are you so fast at selecting? Yeah, I've just been doing it for a long time, I guess. We want to add because we want to add this part back in right here. There we go. Like so. At the top of this building back in. Alright, so we're going to subtract this part of the building right here. There we go. Now hopefully here, if we do a select and then invert, we're actually selecting this bottom part at this point. Now if we do a layer, new layer via copy, what's going to happen is we just got rid of that background. All that gray sky is now gone. That's how easy that is to do. See, if I turn it back on here, if I click the eyeball and make it visual again, you can see it, and we can turn it off and hide it. So we're going to leave that off. And we're going to rename this layer. No sky. Just like so. And this, folks, helps you with your workflow. If you start naming layers, you're going to be better off, because then when you click on these layers, you're going to know what you're clicking on as you're building this picture up. Now, the next step we want to do is we want to replace the sky. So what we want to do here is actually we're going to go to File, Open, because I have a picture of a sky. Let me think where I put it. I think I put under this blue here. Here we go, right here. Clear blue sky. That's what I want to use for this picture. Now, if you're looking for skies, I know on one of the DVDs in particular, I talk about a website, actually a guy's blog. But I guess the show is pretty popular because you guys actually took his blog down. He had to take it offline. So I'm sorry to say that I gave the guy some popularity there through the shows. And unfortunately, I had to take his website down, so I do feel bad. But that does happen occasionally. So I found this one. If you go to Google Images and just type in blue sky, and then click on large image because you want the best size sky that you can get. Let's click on open. We're going to open that sky right here. All right, now what we're going to do is we're going to take this sky and we are going to do a selection on it. And then we're just going to drag it right on top of our picture and let it go. Now, with that, we're going to just stretch the sky out. And folks, don't worry about what you're covering up. You'll do just fine. Stretch the sky out here. There we go. Pull it over. Once you get it where you want to, hit the Enter key. That'll lock it in. Or you can click the checkbox. Let's rename this layer. Let's rename it Blue Sky. Now, as you see there, we have a workflow going on, Blue Sky. Now, remember with layers, you've seen this multiple times, any layer that's on top of another layer is going to be the one showing foremost or showing in the foreground, right? So now, to get that blue sky and to get our city in front of the blue sky, just pull it above it. And there you go. Now we have a really nice blue sky. Remember, this is kind of what it looked like. There you go. Let's shut this off. That's what it looked like originally, though, the sky. And now we have that nice, crisp blue sky in the background. Now I thought, well, that's pretty good, but what we got to do now is work on this bottom part here. So again, what we're going to do is make another selection. So let's get our quick selection tool here. Go back to the plus, and we're going to make another selection. This time we're going to select the water. Right across there. Now, if you really want to get fancy, we can go in here. We can actually kind of clear these boats out a little bit because we don't really want to change the boats as much as we want to change the water. We're going to lower our brush size down here a little bit. Some of the boats further off in the background, I wouldn't worry too much about those. All right, there we go. So we got that. Now, let's click on this one. Okay, to make sure it's visual. And we're just going to change this water. Now again, all we have to do now is we're going to add a hue and saturation. But what we're going to work on is we're just going to work on to get that water as blue as possible. Okay, so we don't want people to overextend these. It's just a matter of timing and playing with these sliders. And there we go. See how easy it was to get that water blue? Now this is, says hue and saturation. We are going to rename this layer. Blue water. Now at that point you do have your workflow going on. Now as you can see here, we have blue water, no sky in this one, blue sky here. And these two layers still remain left off. You don't need to turn these two layers back on. This layer, actually, we should be able to just go up here and delete. And the background layer is locked, so you're not going to delete that layer. You're going to keep it lit. So that is basically how you create a workflow. You see how we changed the water without changing the boats because we had those selected. We selected the water and then deselected the boats, so they stay their normal, natural color. Well, folks, I hope you've enjoyed this video tutorial on using a bit of workflow. And by all means, if you enjoyed this tutorial, remember, jump over to jackstechcorner.com and look for those DVDs. I'm sure you will be extremely happy you bought them. You have lots and lots of feedback. I've sold these things. You know, people all over the world are buying the DVDs. So if you live anywhere outside the U.S., by all means, I do ship to you. So by all means, put your order in, and the DVDs are normally shipped the next day. Okay, folks, so until next time, always remember, keep those shutters clicking, Don't worry if you get a bad shot. Don't delete it too fast. Get it home, put it in the editor, and have a look. Maybe you can straighten it up or fix it. And keep the editors editing. And I'll see you back here next time on Jack's Tech Corner. Bye for now.